to welcome our two guests. This is Kiyoshi Kametani.
Hello.
Hi. You can call him Kametani-san. This is Toshinori Esumi. And for you, Toshi. Kametani-san. Okay. So he prefers Kametani-san. It's a more, you know, respectable address. So they are in Team A, and just a little bit of introduction. They're both based in Izumo, and when I met them for the first time was via Satoru's, I mean, his hometown is Izumo, so this is the first workshop. They're local architects in Izumo, but they're practicing all around the regional areas in Dubai, through to Osaka, teaching at local universities. Kametani-san's office is NAK, Architectural Office, stand for M-A-K. Maybe what? Just sounds cool.
Nadia.
So his partner is Nadia, and A is and comes on. Sounds cool. Okay, so it's just you. I'm sorry, I didn't get the name. And Esumi-san has an atelier office, so a small practice with three staff. They are doing the lecture on Wednesday night, so tomorrow night from 8 o'clock. So, again, I will translate those after the speaker.
Is that good?
Newcastle
proposed as a photo of four children from that group. And we both with them in a Japanese tea room instead of four. The room is a special meeting space. All help economic growth and mass production of household goods, available transport, all instead of coal, economic growth much more, and global environment change. Household goods no longer needed. Hang small, something deep on the floor. Because the 20th century, think of the energy and protection, the environment and civilization, human nature. This bureau proposed to think about the contemporary issues. Do you understand?
Yes, you understand. Yes. So some questions
on that.
Chashitsu is tea room.
Very small space.
So they sit face to face, and it's not just about the tea, it's a very special form of communication. And you can translate the other one. Was it Ichigo? Ichigo? Something like one to one. Anyone else? It's intimate? Yeah? Something? So it's about sort of when someone arrives in the past, the tea is a special way to offer
hospitality.
So the project basically is they've been given a venue which is On the bottom of the front page where it says Cold Tea Room, that little box set, that little empty, it's not a McDonald's or a hundred bucks or something. Yes, Life Size Room. It's a big sort of empty room on the ground floor near the footbridge. So this team's got that room for the next 3.5 days to design a tea room as a space that people on a closing day can be invited to come to, and they've they brought some specialty from Japan, so that part of the design project will be about an architectural question about how do we design a space. And one of the things he pointed out that you know, might be really interesting is to have a new version of the wet and dry elements in the tea room. So there's some water elements, I presume, versus dry elements, but maybe it's, you know, it's a question that also needs to be really fleshed out. So the theme is sort of quite a complex one. It's looking at energy change from coal to oil, and you know, that's a sort of a larger picture thing that if people from Newcastle were in the team, they'd be able to give more context and information around. And so in a sense, what the project is about is to design an experience via the architectural space, how the tea event happens. And then the time slot is from 3 o'clock on Saturday. And maybe it's good to ask a couple of questions while you have them, because this is really a different issue. So his point was it's not just about designing the space, it's about designing the ceremony and the performance of giving outsiders tea.
Of course, not only drawing and water, of course.
Actually, you're transforming the whole space.
And enjoy it.
So the room itself at the moment has some enormous big leftover pieces of timber.
There were big Christmas boxes that were anyone who passed
from
those big things
are
as
for the
same
One of the challenges for the project is to have a really low budget and produce a really high impact thing. We've worked with $100 budgets once with Satori on Cockatoo Island in Sydney. I don't know if many people know that, but it's the place where Cockatoo Festival and things have happened. It's a really amazing space. And once there with $100, we filled the whole turbine hall, which is 100 meters long, a big missile, 25 meters wide, with sound, light, and so each team is given $300 budget to do obviously a lot more.
I just have a question with the exploration of the coal part of the rooms. Is that looking at kind of like the economic benefits of the coal industry as well as the environmental impacts and climate change and those things? Is that kind of...
I think that's right, yeah. If in that team, the notes that you had that along my way before, that's pretty sure. I think what has happened is he's got the great translation there that maybe didn't sound kind of very clearly about Israel. Oh, no. And we talk about other minimums, so maybe if there's a way of maybe sort of asking for a little bit more detail. So one thing that I didn't explain is that he has an idea to burn existing household objects or to singe them to make them look like coal, and to somehow have a display or an art installation or some kind of arrangement of these objects in and around the tea room. So it's a highly transformative experience of the tea room. So that's, I mean, all of these projects, we're putting together themes, but every single one of them will be transformed depending on the people that join this team. So these are just ideas to get started. So, yeah, any other questions?